Last month, Parliament passed the Anti-Homosexuality Bill 2023, which criminalizes homosexual activities. Despite several calls from the public for the President to fast-track and assent to this bill, it's yet to be signed into law. Today, NRM members of Parliament have learnt of an invitation by the President, who doubles as the NRM party chairperson, summoning them to discuss, among other things, the anti-gay bill. The invitation, which has been signed by the government chief whip, indicates that the meeting will take place on Thursday at State House Entebbe at 2 p.m., as the caucus spokesperson, Honorable Brandon Chintu, confirms.
This time around, the communication has been clear. We're also going to talk about the bill we just passed in Parliament, the homosexuality bill. We are not faulting any procedure, but it's also important as members of the same party to reflect a little further, understand, and also closely bring out the pressure, because this is something that protects our values and norms as a country, which we should also emphasize more in the NRM Parliamentary Caucus.
Despite several calls, especially from the international community, for President Museveni not to sign the bill into law, MPs vow not to shift from the earlier position, saying the fate of the bill was done and dusted.
As Parliament, we did our part, and we passed the anti-homosexuality bill, and we did some consultations. We even made some quotations from the Bible and the Quran, how bad the anti-homosexual is. But again, the law allows the president that before he assents the bill, if there is any additional or subtraction or a new idea he wants to introduce, he can make a recommendation.
We want to appreciate the meeting as a consultative meeting, but we will remain firm with our position that this country cannot be surrendered. We cannot surrender our values, and we will remain a religious country that obeys the teachings of Allah and God that say a man must marry a woman and a woman must get married to a man.
Some assume that maybe the president is inviting them to witness the assent of the bill, saying they will not strike any compromise on the matter.
This is something we discussed at length, and a decision was taken. However, because there was a minority report, maybe there are things we are going to be advised legally. Maybe legally this can't work because of this law in the constitution.
I wouldn't like to see the president invite members of parliament to consult them. The only option the president has are two. One, to either sign the law, to sign the bill into law, or to return it with the amendments.
During today's parliament session, it was established that the Attorney General, Chiriowa Chiwanuka, has already written to the president, advising him against assenting to the anti-gay bill. They accused Chiwanuka of betraying the trust of the House since his deputy took part in the making of the bill.
Deputy Attorney General of the Republic of Uganda is strongly writing to the president, de-associating himself with the act, the Anti-Homosexuality Act, which we passed in Parliament.
The Office of the Attorney General did render advice to the President in the legislative process. I would request that Parliament does allow this process to continue. It would be absurd to say, this is, if you put it out here, what if the person they're advising is not agreeing with the advice?
We cannot stop the Attorney General, the Attorney General's office, from performing their duty of advising the president. Number two, for now, we can hear in rumors, we don't have exact information.
However, the caucus spokesperson, Brandon Chintu, says the meeting will also tackle the issues of iron sheets, which has embarrassed several top government officials.
We shall also discuss so many things that have been on. We know we have court processes going on, this saga of the iron sheets and Karamoja issues. We hadn't discussed or fluently spoken with the chairman of the party. So this time, we're going to discuss and also see how further we can push, because we are cleaning up. We want to still continue and maintain zero tolerance to corruption.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.